You're probably wondering why I'm doing a video on Wordle now instead of when it was a hype like 1.5 years ago. That is actually when I did this project, when it was actually still pretty small. And like any normal, well-adjusted person, I immediately wanted to break it with programming on my Christmas break. So here we are. So to break Wordle, the idea was to write an algorithm that could solve Wordles in as few attempts as possible. But to do that, I first needed to code up the game. So I got started on that. You can tell I could really let my glorious web design skills shine for this one. Anyway, that was done in about 2 days, but only because I'm an idiot and I didn't think to check whether I could steal the original Wordle's words, which you can very easily. So I had to find my own alternative. Well, I didn't have to, but I did. Which is actually the basis for this entire video. So the alternative is kind of interesting. We'll get to that later. Next, I started working on the algorithm, which took a few more days, bringing us to almost the end of the Christmas break. So at this point, I just wanted to make a video about it and move on with my life. So of course, I got right to that. I did not. Because why would I ever finish a project within the intended time frame, right? The following week, 3blue1brown uploaded his video about solving Wordle, and it was so amazing and well explained, thought out, and animated, and everything that all of his videos are, that it made me feel kind of pointless with my potential video. So I just kind of gave up. But to be fair, I didn't really have time to make a video at that point anymore because uni had started again and I was slowly dying from the work. Now time skip to a few months later. I felt like the algorithm was old news at that point, but I still wanted to make something of this project. So I got to thinking, I have friends of many different nationalities here at uni, and I figured it'd be fun if I made Wordle in their languages. So I got started on that. And to illustrate how, let's start with English so that you can all follow along. So first step, without using the original Wordle's words, we need to get all of the English words. But that's simple enough. Just do a Google search and you get plenty of results. All right, so now we just pick our mystery word from this list. Okay, maybe not. And also, why are given names in every single word list I could find? We could just remove all the words with uppercase letters, but it doesn't work because the given names in these word lists are spelled with lowercase. Why? The problem for words that have accents in them is pretty easy to solve because we can just exclude any word that has characters that aren't on the screen keyboard. We'll get to the given names with a little trick later on, which does leave them as valid guesses, but we'll call that a feature. So after we've cleared those invalid words, we can just pick randomly, right? Ah. I would say comment below if you knew this word, but I'm afraid that wouldn't really increase my comments by much. Anyway, there's simply too many obscure words in every language for this method to work, so we need to do some more. Does that mean handpicking every word that can be chosen as the mystery word from the hundreds of thousands of words in the word list? That's what the original Wordle creators did. Over my dead body. I posit that we want words to be chosen that everyone would know, because it kind of ruins the fun of the game if you were trying to find a word and then it turns out it's a word that doesn't even sound like it's a real word. So let's try weighing the probability of picking any particular mystery word by the frequency that it occurs in English. To get these frequencies, we need a lot of English text, so I downloaded 2.3 billion words worth of English Wikipedia articles. But that was 26 uncompressed gigabytes, and I realized that was a little bit overkill. So I switched to just 10 million words. That was still plenty. The next step was some very basic code that literally just reads through the entire text and tallies up the count for each word, or more specifically, each token, which we'll define here as any sequence of characters separated by spaces. For this to make sense, though, we need to first remove all punctuation to prevent things like this, when really it should be this. Okay, so let's weigh the probability of any word by its frequency. And test it. Okay, that's not what we want. Some words are showing up over and over, even in this small sample, and it's all because of Ziffs Law. I never in a million years thought that I would actually apply that shit in my life. Vsauce actually has a great video on Ziffs Law, but I'll simplify it as the most common word is twice as common as the number two, and three times as common as the number three, etc. So these most common words are exponentially more common than the less common words. Of course, this is slightly skewed by the fact that we're only looking at words of length 5 right now, but it does explain why about had a probability of 3%, while number 6, other, had half that, and a word like relax only had 1/100th. To fix this, we need math. But luckily, it's just constructing a simple formula. Okay, that looks unnecessarily complicated, so let's build it up step by step. We begin with this Ziffy curve and slap a logarithm on there to get rid of the exponentiality, and then rescale it to be in a reasonable range for the sigmoid function. We apply the sigmoid because we want this nice little transition area while the most common words and the least common words are kind of on these plateaus. The last thing is to turn these values into a probability distribution adding up to 1. That can simply be done by dividing each value by the sum of all values. And voila, here's our formula. At the tail end of this curve, you've got words like olne, akari, and you write. Words with such low probability will never see them, which is nice because we don't want to. This also goes for the given names that we encountered earlier. This is the little trick I was talking about. Our favorite words like about, other, and relax are now way more balanced. So, we're ready to pick words? Yes, finally we are. Now, as you might know, not all words are in fact 5 letters long. I know. So, on to the next step, using all lengths of words. I'll be honest, this part was an immense undertaking, and it left me so exhausted. Perfect. Okay, now we just repeat this process for all other languages in the world. Luckily, every language has easily accessible and fairly exhaustive lists of words ready to be downloaded. That's sarcasm. Okay, firstly, some languages like Chinese have too many characters to even fit on a keyboard, let alone play Wordle with. Secondly, many languages are just not well documented online and either don't have readily available corpora, which are bodies of text, or even word lists. Eventually, I ended up using the spell checker word lists used for the LibreOffice software, which is open source, so I could freely access all of it, which is amazing. This wasn't perfect though, because for example, Vietnamese has only 6,000 different words in there, which I'm pretty sure is not as many words as they should have for a working language. We'll get to that problem later. First, there's another problem to fix: accents and alphabets. Let's start with accents. Take Italian. Italian has 2 different accents, and they affect the way you pronounce a word.
Perché? Perché? A caldo? A caldo.
I decided to ignore accents altogether because some languages, I'm looking at you, Vietnamese, have a staggering 60 combinations of different accents and vowels, which would make Wordle completely unplayable if taken into account. Now take Czech. This is just an A with an accent, right? Wrong. Czech actually has no accents at all and instead has 42 unique characters, though I still have a little trouble counting CH as one single character, but we'll let that slide. 42 unique characters, as opposed to the measly 26 in English. These extra characters simply have to be added to the Wordle keyboard, just like with any other alphabet like Greek, Thai, and Cyrillic. So I did that. For every language, I entered the keyboard layout and each of its characters. One last thing remained to be done, specifically for Arabic and Hebrew. These backwards languages stand out in one important aspect. Just FYI, this is a real mindfuck when working in a code editor and suddenly your cursor jumps around like this. Anyway, the thing we need to do for these languages, of course, is to reverse the order in which the characters appear. And done. I gotta say, Arabic looks way nicer when it's all connected like this, but I'm tired now. To solve the problem of incomplete word lists, I added an option for users to send missing words to me in a Google form, and if I wanted to spend more time on this project, then I would write a script to automatically pull those from the Google Sheets and push them to the live website. But like I said, I'm tired, and nobody is probably going to play this anymore anyway. So that's basically the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching my first video like this. I really appreciate it. If you want to see more, and I do plan to make more, you can subscribe without worrying about me flooding your notifications if you click that bell, because these videos take time. In fact, God, this video, I don't know why it took so long for me to actually make it. Well, I mean, I kind of do. Like, I didn't know where to start, you know? It's the first video that I've ever really done with a script, and I'm noticing it's much more difficult than just improvising. But I'm very glad that I got it done now. An honorable mention for a language is Korean, which I didn't get to work because of the way that the characters are constructed. It's very unique. It's very cool, actually. It looks very cool. But yeah, it doesn't work with the existing system of the keyboard that I had, and I'd have to basically code the whole app all over again. So this is why I didn't do Korean, even though I did really want to. If you liked the video, please leave a like. It tells the YouTube gods that, you know, I'm driving engagement, which is a good thing. You can also dislike, that also helps. Leave a comment, you know, stuff like that. I appreciate all of it. And, you know, maybe if people want, I can make a video about the algorithm that I made. But I feel like I said before, I feel like that's old news now. I've got other projects that I'd like to code and also talk about. So I'd probably rather do that. A fun fact, the longest word in Lingordle, which is what I called the project, is Belangenbehartigingsorganisatie, which is proudly a word in my own language, Dutch. It's kind of a gimmicky word, which is said a lot to be the longest word in Dutch, which is Houten Totten Tenten Tentoonstelling. But it's kind of like it's a gimmick. It's not really a word that you would use. But Belangenbehartigingsorganisatie actually is. It's a proper word that you could see in a newspaper. So that was pretty fun. Fun fact. So I guess that's my end of video ramble. All right, finally, first video, more than 1.5 years after making the project, but we got it done, guys. One crossed off the list. And now hopefully I can get myself to actually make videos quicker than this. So again, thanks for watching, and I hope you'll see me in the next one. Goodbye.